So now we are going to study about what is continuous wavelet transform. Now remember the way we had scaled, like we had distributed the stuff. So if the basis of this was pi of 2t, then the basis of the new lower resolution was pi of t, and of this wavelet was pi of t, the scaling and the new wavelet. In that sense, if we reduce everything, the factor of scaling, the scaling factor, whenever it reduced by a factor of 2, then we call such as dyadic MRI. We call such MRI is multi-resolution analysis as dyadic. So now, just see. The function, this function, whenever we see f of t, this is what is happening. What is happening? Just tell me. It is getting scaled at every resolution. So we can keep scaling out. We can keep shifting the stuff. So in some sense, if we see the nature of multi-resolution analysis, then we can say that this at any general point, it has some scaling factor. Let me write it in denominator. Okay, let me write it in numerator. So let me say 2 raised to the power some k times. Because we are using dyadic, in factors of 2 it is increasing or decreasing. T minus what we can say. So 2 raised to power k into t. That is what is getting convolved with this signal fd. Or in other sense, okay, in some sense we can also see that f of t is getting dot producted with phi of t minus some shifting parameter divided by some scaling parameter, or let me say tau or something. Why? What is fd convolved with this? It is nothing but integration of f of tau. Or let me say f of tau phi of t minus tau to this power k t minus tau d tau. So in that sense I am trying to say, because this convolution which is happening at each level is nothing but integration. You see, I was telling you only now that f t is constructed by the convolution of the spaces. Similarly, the new FT in the new ring, the basis is formed by this way. So in that sense, if we see any in any resolution, if we have to see that how the function, so wavelet, the wavelet is study of function at various resolutions. So in that sense, if we want to generalize it for any resolution, not just dyadic, then the general formula for the wavelet CWT of the shift by tau and the scaling by S is equal to the dot product. Okay, let me write it in dot product form only. The dot product of f of t with this psi of t minus tau by the scaling factor s. You can write it in numerator also by scaling inverse. Okay. But I am writing it in standard form. So this is what is continuous wavelet transform. It is similar to STFT. The STFT was f of t g of t minus u e raised to the power j zeta t. It was inner product with this. Now inner product of ft gt, first of all, is equal to f integration of f into g star dt. Okay, I am not writing t also, just to explain you, simplify stuff. So that is how the inner product happens. Okay. So in that sense, STFT was inner product. Similarly, what is Fourier transform? Just tell me. Fourier transform is nothing but inner product of FT with e raised power j omega t. Similarly, all the different transformations. And the inverse is this continuous wavelet transform. You can derive it by this some ways and different ways. But let me directly state you that the inverse Fourier inverse wavelet transform is nothing but 1 upon c psi inner product of cwt with psi this is over space so now this inner product is over tau ns and this inner product was over t so what will happen is that we will create this will be a matrix over tau and s and we will multiply this two dimensional signal with a two dimensional signal and only time factor will be remaining so this will be integration of cwt psi of t minus tau by s d tau ds 1 upon c psi while here it will be integration over time so this is how it happens so by this you get a basic how do we are getting the formulas of continuous wavelet transform but let us also try to understand even a bit more because this is very important how the different representations of wavelet transform different representations now if you take this function what is the formula for wavelet transform integration phi f of t psi of t minus u or tau by s dt this is what is the formula or if you just rearrange it in some sense it is nothing but f of t convolved with psi of minus t by s. just try to think over it think about this point just think because this is f of similarly to tau t is equal to approximately equal to tau this is psi of minus of t tau minus t or if I write this some sense okay. minus of minus t plus tau divided by s so it is similar to f of tau psi of t minus tau in if I take this as a function wait me this so this is t is equal to tau approximately let me name it as u for simplicity then it is f of tau psi of u minus tau because I have taken t as the tau then this function will be equal to wavelet transform of u comma s so this is similar to convolution and that's why just try to derive it it will come out to be ft convolved with psi of minus t upon s so in that sense in the similar prospect what I can say is that when I break this system take this input as ft this psi of minus t by s what I get is the continuous cwt of u comma or tau comma s anyway okay this tau is on nothing but t only in some sense, okay? So t comma s, the shifting parameter and the scaling parameter. This t we will write is just replace this t, just replace this t by u or tau anyways, okay? So this will lead us to what we can. Now you must understand what is called Plancherals or Parseval's theorem. What does Parseval's theorem say? Parseval's theorem states that ft g star t dt is equal to 1 upon 2 times 2 pi times f of omega g star of omega d omega. So in that sense, in the similar way, if the signal is f of t psi of t minus u upon s dt, then it is also equivalently written as f of omega, the scaling factor, first of all, the Fourier transform of psi of t minus u, so c by s. It is first of all scaled by s. So the scaling by s, so this u factor, this I can write this signal as psi of t by s convolved with delta of t minus u. So the convolution will become e raised to the power minus j omega u, and this scaling t by s will become psi of s omega, s times psi of s omega, because the, you know, you remember this formula f of a t has the Fourier transform 1 upon a times f of omega by a. So by the similar context I am writing only. So this will become this Fourier transform, because the multiplication with this is conjugate only, psi star of this this I am writing as small psi and this is capital psi, okay? So psi bar I am writing, okay? For simplicity, psi bar is in the frequency Fourier function s omega times s d omega and 1 by 2 pi. So these both are equivalent, both of them will give me nothing but CWD of tau comma tau comma scaling function. So you can use either this or that by Parseval's theorem. This is a very powerful theorem, very powerful. So by this you get what exactly this some mathematical aspect of it is, and I guess this is more than enough, I guess, nothing else for this lecture.